Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this short video, we will see the grouping rules for the K-map. So if we know these rules, then we can easily minimize any Boolean expression. So the first rule is, while minimizing any Boolean expression, all the ones in the K-map should be covered. For example, here in this two variable K-map, if we have a two ones, then during the minimization, using the grouping, all the ones should get covered. Similarly, in the three variable K-map, for some function, if we have a four ones, then during the minimization, by making the groups, all the ones should get covered. Now the question is, how to perform this grouping? So for the grouping, we can group the adjacent cells, which are differing by only one variable. For example, if you see over here, that in the first two cells, the variable A is not changing. While if you see the variable B, then it is changing as we go from the minterm M0 to M1. So here, since only one variable is changing, so it is possible to group these two minterms. Similarly, in the three variable K map, if you see the minterm M0 and the M1, then here, only this variable C is changing. And if we see the other two variables, that is variable A and the B, then they are not changing. That means here, we can combine these two minterms. And this group corresponds to A bar dot B bar, because here, the value of the variable A and B is equal to 0. Likewise, in the minterm M4 and the M5, since only variable C is changing, so it is possible to combine these two minterms. And this group corresponds to A dot B bar. And further, if you see these two groups, then in between these two groups, only one variable is changing, that is the variable A. So once again, it is possible to combine these two groups. And in this way, it is possible to make even larger group. So that is how the grouping can be done in the K-map. Now these groups should be in the power of 2. That means the size of the group can be in the power of 2, like 1 to 4, 8 or 16. So as you can see, in this two variable K map, this is the example of the group of 2. While in this three variable K map, using the grouping, these four minterms are combined. And likewise, if it is not possible to make the group of 2, 4 or the 8, then we can also consider each minterm individually. Then if we see the next K map rule, then it is relevant to this present rule. That means the grouping is done either in the square or the rectangular shape. And we have already seen that earlier. But the grouping in any other shape is not allowed. Similarly, if we see the next K-map grouping rule, then during the grouping, this overlapping of the group is allowed. For example, in this two variable K-map, these three minterms can be covered by making these two groups. And as you can see over here, these two groups are overlapping with each other. So in the K-map, during the minimization, such overlapping is allowed. And the same is the case in the three variable as well as the four variable K-map. Then if we see the next K-map rule, then that is related to the wrap around in this K-map. So as you know, since the K-map is the cyclic, so the cells on the edges can be combined for the minimization. For example, here the cell number 0 and the 2 can be combined. Because if you see over here, then between these two cells, only one variable is changing. And similarly, the cell number 4 and the 6 can be clubbed during the minimization. So here, in this given K map, since we have the minterm M0 and the M2, then as per this rule, they can be combined. And similarly, the entire group of the minterms on the edges can be also combined. So since the K-map is the cyclic, so we can combine these four minterms. Similarly, if we have a four variable K-map, then the minterms on the top and the bottom sides can also be combined. So in the given K-map, these two minterms on the top as well as the bottom can be combined. And likewise, the minterms on the left and the right edges can also be combined. That means here, in the given K-map, these four min terms, that is min term m4 and the m12, as well as min term m6 and the m14 can be combined. And based on these rules, the min terms on the four corners of the k-map can also be combined. And likewise, since the k-map is the cyclic, so these are the other different possibilities of combining the min terms which are on the edges of the k-map. So of course, we can combine the min terms which are on the edges. But here, we cannot make the group of the min terms which are on the opposite corner. Because here, if you see between these two min terms, then here more than two variables are changing. So we can say that these two cells are not adjacent to each other. And therefore, we cannot make the group of these two min terms. And similarly, the same is the case for the min term m0 and the m12. Then the next rule is, during the minimization, the grouping can be either vertical or the horizontal. But the diagonal grouping is not allowed. The reason is, the cells located diagonally are not adjacent to each other. Because here, if you move from the cell number 5 to the 15, then here, more than one variable is changing. And that's why, these two cells are not adjacent to each other. And that is why, it is not possible to combine these two min terms. That means the diagonal grouping is not allowed in the k-map. And the last rule is, during the minimization, make the groups which are as large as possible. And try to cover all the ones in the k-map using the minimum number of groups. For example, in this k-map, these four ones can be covered by making these two groups. But here, instead of that, it is possible to make the group of four ones. Likewise, in this case, these four min terms on the left and the right edge of the k-map can be combined. And similarly, it is also possible to combine these four min terms. And in this way, by making just two groups, it is possible to cover all the ones in the k-map. So these are the grouping rules for the k-map. And using these rules, it is possible to minimize any Boolean expression of 2, 3 or the 4 variables.